Daily Words of God. How Satan Uses Knowledge to Corrupt Man. First, we will talk about knowledge. Is knowledge something that everyone considers to be a positive thing? At the very least, people think that the connotation of the word knowledge is positive rather than negative. So why are we mentioning here that Satan uses knowledge to corrupt man? Is the theory of evolution not an aspect of knowledge? Are Newton's scientific laws not a part of knowledge? The gravitational pull of the Earth is also a part of knowledge, is it not?
Yes.
So why is knowledge listed among the things that Satan uses to corrupt mankind? What is your view on this? Does knowledge have even a shred of truth in it?
No.
Then what is the substance of knowledge? On what basis is all the knowledge that man acquires learned? Is it based on the theory of evolution? Is not the knowledge that man has gained through exploration and summation based on atheism? Does any of this knowledge have a connection to God? Is it connected with worshiping God? Is it connected to truth?
No.
So how does Satan use knowledge to corrupt man? I just said that none of this knowledge is connected with worshiping God or with truth. Some people think about it like this. Knowledge might not have anything to do with truth. But still, it doesn't corrupt people. What is your view on this? Were you taught by knowledge that a person's happiness must be created with their own two hands? Did knowledge teach you that man's fate was in his own hands?
Yes.
What kind of talk is this?
It is nonsense.
Absolutely right. It is nonsense. Knowledge is a complicated subject to discuss. You may state simply that a field of knowledge is nothing more than knowledge. That is a field of knowledge that is learned on the basis of not worshiping God and on not understanding that God created all things. When people study this type of knowledge, they do not see God having sovereignty over all things. They do not see God being in charge of or managing all things. Instead, all they do is endlessly research and explore that area of knowledge and seek out answers based on knowledge. However, is it not true that if people do not believe in God and instead only pursue research, they will never find the true answers? All that knowledge can give you is a livelihood, a job, income so that you do not go hungry. But it will never make you worship God, and it will never keep you far from evil. The more you study knowledge, the more you will desire to rebel against God, to subject God to your studies, to tempt God, and to resist God. So what do we now see that knowledge is teaching people? It is all the philosophy of Satan. Do the philosophies and rules of survival spread by Satan among corrupt men have any relation to truth? They have nothing to do with truth, and in fact, are the opposite of the truth. People often say, "Life is motion, and man is iron. Rice is steel. Man feels famished if he skips a meal." What are these sayings? They are fallacies, and hearing them causes a feeling of disgust. In man's so-called knowledge, Satan has imbued quite a bit of its philosophy for living and its thinking. And as Satan does this, it allows man to adopt its thinking, philosophy, and points of view, so that man may deny the existence of God, deny God's dominion over all things, and over man's fate. So as man's studies progress and he gains more knowledge, he feels the existence of God become vague and might even no longer feel that God exists. As Satan has added viewpoints, notions, and thoughts into the mind of man, is not man corrupted during this process?
Yes.
What does man now base his life upon? Is he really living on the basis of this knowledge? No. Man is basing his life on the thoughts, views, and philosophies of Satan that are hidden within this knowledge. This is where the essential part of Satan's corruption of man occurs. This is both Satan's goal and its method for corrupting man. We will start by addressing the most superficial aspect of knowledge. Are the grammar and words in languages able to corrupt people? Can words corrupt people?
No.
Words do not corrupt people. They are a tool that people use to speak, and they are also the tool with which people communicate with God. Not to mention that at present, language and words are how God communicates with people. They are tools, and they are a necessity. 1 + 1 = 2, and 2 × 2 = 4. Is this not knowledge? But can this corrupt you? This is common knowledge. It is a fixed pattern, and so it cannot corrupt people. So what type of knowledge does corrupt people? Corrupting knowledge is knowledge that is intermingled with Satan's viewpoints and thoughts. Satan seeks to inculcate these viewpoints and thoughts into humanity through the medium of knowledge. For example, in an article, there is nothing wrong with the written words in themselves. The problem lies with the viewpoints and intent of the author when they wrote the article, as well as the content of their thoughts. These are things of the spirit, and they are able to corrupt people. For example, if you were watching a television show, what sort of things in it could change people's view? Would what the performers said, the words themselves, be able to corrupt people?
No.
What sort of things would corrupt people? It would be the core thoughts and content of the show, which would represent the director's views. The information carried in these views could sway people's hearts and minds. Is that not so? Now you know what I am referring to in my discussion of Satan using knowledge to corrupt people. You will not misunderstand, will you? So the next time you read a novel or an article, will you be able to evaluate whether or not the thoughts expressed in the written words corrupt mankind or contribute to humanity?
Yes, to a small extent.
This is something that must be studied and experienced at a slow pace, and it is not something that is easily understood right away. For example, when researching or studying an area of knowledge, some positive aspects of that knowledge may help you understand some general knowledge about that field, while also enabling you to know what people should avoid. For example, take electricity. This is a field of knowledge, is it not? Would you not be ignorant if you did not know that electricity can shock and hurt people? But once you understand this field of knowledge, you will not be careless about touching objects with electrical currents, and you will know how to use electricity. These are both positive things. Are you now clear on what we have been discussing in terms of how knowledge corrupts people? There are many types of knowledge studied in the world, and you must take your time to differentiate them for yourselves.